The Philippines sets the Guinness World Record for the biggest human lung formation, beating the previous mark set by India. Job Manahan gives us a look.
The Philippines set a new world record for the largest human image of an organ this Saturday after forming a human lung at the Quirino Grandstand in Manila to commemorate World Tuberculosis Day this year. For the lung formation, the Philippines had 5,596 participants, beating India's record of 5,003 participants in 2017. An adjudicator at the Guinness World Record said, in order to win, they had to consider the number of participants and the form of the human lung. There should also be no gaps between individuals during the official recording of the photo. Guinness gave three attempts. The Philippines managed to snag the record during the second attempt. One of the participants, Oswald Macapagal, said he was excited to join the event. He was already at the Quirino Grandstand before 5 a.m. to participate in the activity.
Gumising nga kami ng maaga kasi excited kami. Kumbaga parang ito yung isang malaking, magiging malaking maibabahagi namin, especially hindi lang sa Pilipinas, even the whole world, di ba, na yung TB nga is kailangan natin labanan para nga rin sa health natin, di ba?
Health Secretary Ted Herbosa was all smiles when the Philippines set the new record. However, he reminded Filipinos the importance of getting checked for tuberculosis as this was the main advocacy of their event.
Lahat kayo, maraming salamat. Nakita nyo, hindi madali mag-attempt ng world record. Napaka-stricto ng rules at hindi natin ito magagawa kung hindi tayo magtulong-tulong at magbayan yan. Ganun din sana mangyari para matuldukan natin ang TB. Ang TB ay isang sakit na matagal nang nandito sa ating bayan at kaya namang gamutin sa proseso ng pag-test, ng x-ray, ng molecular test at mga gamot. Available po yan.
The Department of Health earlier said TB cases in the Philippines surged in 2023. A total of 612,000 TB cases were reported last year. This is equivalent to approximately 549 cases per 100,000 population, marking an increase from 439 cases per 100,000 in 2022. To combat tuberculosis, Herbosa stressed the importance of seeking prompt X-ray and molecular confirmation for individuals with symptoms, emphasizing the critical need for timely medication. Job Manahan, ABS-CBN News.
A new film starring Anthony Hopkins arrives in theaters. Our resident movie critic Manny the Movie Guy tells us all about the latest in cinemas and on streaming.
Do you ever think about the children and what happened to them?
Sir Anthony Hopkins is brilliant in the true-to-life emotional tale of Nicholas Winton, a British broker who helped rescue hundreds of mostly Jewish children in Czechoslovakia from the Nazis.
In Britain.
Has such a great big heart and I love it.
He has a great big heart. Winton had a great big heart. We should have more Wintons in this world.
You have to forgive yourself that.
Helena Bonham Carter stars as Nicholas's mom who teaches him compassion and determination. You will cry with the joy when you see the rescued children appear on the BBC's That's Life to Winton's surprise. One Life celebrates humanity, and I'm strongly recommending this film that gets 3.5 out of 4, A Remarkable Life, kisses. And the latest releases on streaming that I'm recommending begins with Paramount Plus's Little Wing.
Oh, cool, I get to work with pigeons. Yeah. So
you may remember Brooklyn Prince as the little girl in the Florida Project. She's a bit older now, playing the role of Caitlin, who turns to pigeon racing as a means to survive.
One of his birds is valued at $120,000.
On Amazon Prime, the amazing life of Frida Kahlo told through her own words in the documentary Frida.
Necesito pintar.
And on Netflix, Lindsay Lohan returns in the charming romantic comedy Irish Wish. So I gave her and co-star Ayesha Curry my Irish Wish.
May both of you live as long as you want and never want as long as you live.
Ooh.
Isn't that amazing?
Thank you.
And finally, Netflix saves the super funny show Girls 5 Eva from cancellation. The one-hit wonder girl group lives. Check out season 3 right now.
I could not get it out of my head.
Which one?
The beginning. The intro.
Yes. Forever, cause forever's too short.
Too short.
Gonna be famous forever.
I'm Manny the Movie Guy for ABS-CBN News.
So what are you waiting for?
Oh, magaling na singer-songwriter yan. And that's Dateline Philippines Weekend. I am Rica Lazo. Thank you for joining us. Keep it here on ANC.
Watching ANC,
the ABS-CBN News Channel.
You will also have exclusive access to on-demand business news, lifestyle, and other content you've come to expect from ANC.
And to even receive exclusive members-only perks like photos and videos and even badges and emojis. All these at your fingertips wherever your internet connection is available.
To ANC 24/7 on YouTube and click join to become a member.
Welcome to ANC Prestige.
This is the Philippines. We are ANC.
Good afternoon. I am Rica Lazo. Here are the biggest overseas stories at this hour on ANC. No end in sight to the bloody war on Gaza. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu on Friday greenlit plans for another ground offensive in Gaza city of Rafah, where over a million displaced residents are taking shelter. Netanyahu argues Rafah is one of the last strongholds of Hamas, whom it has pledged to eliminate. The United Nations warns Israel's planned attack would worsen the already catastrophic humanitarian situation in the Strip. Rafah is the last relatively safe city in the war-torn enclave.
I think the consequences of a ground operation in Rafah in the current circumstances would be catastrophic for the people of Gaza, for the Palestinians. It would be catastrophic for the humanitarian situation. It would be catastrophic all around. We very much hope that all of this can be avoided. We understand there's negotiations are still going on, and we continue to hope that we will find that the parties will find a way to a ceasefire to ensure the greater humanitarian access, to ensure the release of all the hostages held by Hamas and others in Gaza.
The Gaza-based Palestinian Health Ministry on Friday reported the Palestinian death toll due to the ongoing Israeli attacks on the besieged enclave now stands at 31,490. Vladimir Putin accuses Ukraine of trying to disrupt Russia's presidential election, which is expected to solidify its hold onto power until 2030. The first of 3 days of voting was marred by disruptions, including dye being poured into ballot boxes in a Molotov cocktail thrown at a polling station in Putin's hometown. Putin vows the perpetrators will not go unpunished.
Presidential elections have begun. In an attempt to disrupt the voting process and intimidate people, at least in the regions bordering Ukraine, the Kyiv neo-Nazi regime has planned and is trying to carry out a series of criminal, demonstrative armed actions. Unfortunately, we have casualties among civilians. All of them and their families will undoubtedly be provided all the necessary assistance and support. These enemy strikes are not and will not remain unpunished.
Putin's statement comes on the heels of a Russian missile strike in Odessa on Friday, which killed 20 and wounded 70 more. Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky earlier said Russia would receive a fair response from his forces. And over in Sudan, the UN reports around 5 million people there could face severe hunger as a nearly year-long war between rival generals continue to tear the country apart. The organization adds 18 million Sudanese are already facing acute food insecurity, a record during harvest season. In light of this, the UN, in a letter to Sudan's Security Council, has appealed to the battling factions in Sudan to allow the delivery of humanitarian relief. The war between Sudan's army chief and his former deputy is blamed for the loss of tens of thousands of lives and has crippled the economy since April.